Next, let's talk about how to upload your media to the core and how to manage the core's capacity for media playback. This is going to take place in the core manager, which means that, of course, you'll need an actual core if you want to follow along with this. It also means that everything you see in this video could also be accomplished remotely through QSYS Reflect Enterprise Manager, which gives you access to the core manager of any of your systems from a single dashboard. You should know by now that you can access the core manager in a number of ways. Entering its IP address in any web browser is one option. Following the link in the QSYS configurator is another one. You could select this icon at the top of a running design to get there. Or, like I just mentioned, you can use your QSYS Reflect Enterprise Manager account to access the core manager of any of your connected systems. Regardless of how you get there, let's navigate to the Files tab, where you'll see a number of pre-created root folders: Audio, Messages, Page Archives, Preambles, and Ringtones. Some of these folders are specifically targeted by particular components in QSYS, but for general audio, we're just going to open the Audio folder. If you'd like to organize your audio files into subfolders, you can make a new folder with this icon. Or you can select the Upload Files icon to start transferring files from your PC to the core. The core can accept WAV files, MP3s, or FLAC files. You'll see a status bar of your upload progress in the corner of the screen, and once the transfer is complete, you can find your file listed in the main window. Here you can see its file type and size, and you can audition the file to play over your PC speakers to listen to it. You could also download a file to your PC from the core. You could edit a file's name or delete it using these icons. To select multiple files, simply hold down the Control key. Next, let's create some playlists. First, navigate to the Playlists window and select the plus button to create a new playlist and give it an appropriate name. If you investigate that playlist, you can see it has no tracks in it at the moment. So let's select a couple of songs and press this icon to add them to the playlist of our choice. You can then reorder those tracks by dragging them up or down in the playlist order, or you could delete them again with the trash bin icon. Once you've created a playlist, that playlist will be shown as an option within any audio player that is playlist capable, which will also display the current song in that playlist and give you track navigation buttons. One other thing to note in Core Manager is this. In the upper right corner, it shows you the total amount of disk space available on your core's internal drive. If you're using a lot of audio files in your design, and especially if those are WAV files, you might want to consider upgrading your core storage capacity. A new media drive can only be purchased through your sales channel. Different cores have different options for available media drives, so be sure to check out which options are available for your core model. Installation instructions are included with the drive. All media drive options can be installed in the field by any technician with a basic understanding of computer hardware, but not, and I cannot stress this enough, by a dog. However, adding more storage capacity for your audio files doesn't change the fact that by default, you're still limited to 16 total audio track channels in your design. If you want to upgrade this, you'll need to install the multi-track player feature license to your core to expand its total number of audio player tracks. Once again, there are different tiers available here, so be sure to check out which ones are available for your core model. Also, please be aware that if you use any of the MTP feature licenses on your core, you also must upgrade your media drive from its default size as well. Simple instructions for installing feature licenses are available online and are also included when you make your purchase. For systems running a redundant core, both cores will obviously need the same media drive upgrade and MTP license. However, don't worry about uploading all of your media to both cores. Once the design is running on your primary core, that core will automatically sync and transfer its audio files to your backup core to make sure they always match. Finally, one last thing about audio management, specifically if you're using pre-recorded announcements. If you're thinking about using audio players to play different messages for public address in your design, you may want to think again. While it's certainly a viable option for simple venues, it would be quite cumbersome to rely on a bunch of audio players to play back multiple announcements across a larger installation. Not to mention, it would quickly exhaust your audio track account. Instead, look to the public address components, which are covered in some of our more advanced quick start training videos. These can dynamically play any number of announcements to multiple zones in a variety of manners, and they don't count against your total available audio track count. Just be sure to load your announcements to the Messages root folder, which is where your page stations will look for their files. All right, let's take a break right there and come back whenever you're ready.